back to the action here. It's a fatal four match. And yes, you see Vaughn Kreed and Lord Magma in the ring. This is indeed a fatal four-way match. Whoever wins that will get the fourth and final spot in the one-way ticket Money in the Bank ladder match. You see Vaughn Kreed, Lord Magma, Jamie Heineman, Luke Fowler duking it out here. And already the likes of Gene Starwind, Samoa Joe, and Vicious have filled out the ranks of the Money in the Bank ladder match. I love it, first fight.
This Vaughn Creed's going for the cover, and very surprisingly, Lord Magma actually allowing Vaughn Kreed to, you know, attempt that three count there. But now that was only a near fall, they go back in that double team where that double handed chokes him from both members of Nation of Violence. And that's exactly where I got a question. I mean, this is not a tag team match, folks. This is indeed a fatal four way.
Yeah, I mean, of course, we all knew at some point Lord Magma and Vaughn Kreed were going to be in cahoots, working together in this matchup. The only variable we can come up with perhaps is will Jamie Heineman, Luke Fowler, perhaps will they be able to work together and divide and conquer the Nation of Violence, or will Lord Magma and Vaughn Kreed work together till the very end of this matchup? Remember, folks, only one could win. Look at this, and Luke Fowler once again finding himself on the receiving end of that Judgment Slam. It's not the first time he felt the Hell's Gatekeeper's fury. Look at this. And now Jamie Heineman go for a ride with that double choke on by Vaughn Kreed and Lord Magma. Oh, that huge uppercut.
Lord Magma does not go for the cover there. He's going to go right after Jamie Heineman once again and attempt this in a second choke slam right after the double choke slam. But he's not. Oh, my. At least that wasn't to the outside, but still another choke slam. And Vaughn Kreed, look inside the left side of your screen, folks. Vaughn Kreed's got Luke got throttled here. He tried to get out of it, but in the end ate that aneurysm. Oh my, I think that might have busted open the Ace of Spades, and oh my! I think that might have killed badass Jamie Heineman there, that Judgment Slam, you know, right on his neck.
Look at this, oh. This happened to Luke Fowler on the announce table before. It's like Luke Fowler's been receiving it this time, but oh, it's that Hell's Gate driver is contorting Luke's body in half, dropping around his neck with a modified Death Valley driver there, and look at that, folks. Lord Magma gets the win. Vaughn Kreed absolutely just allowed Lord Magma to get the win. And very uncharacteristic of Vaughn Kreed. Vaughn Kreed would use every underhanded tactic to get the win. We all thought he would perhaps betray Lord Magma here tonight. And that didn't even happen. For some reason, Vaughn Kreed actually allowing Lord Magma to get that final spot in the one-way ticket Money in the Bank ladder match. It definitely doesn't add up in my mind. But look at this. If you see Lord Magma and Vaughn Kreed absolutely dominated this matchup here, just divided and conquered Jimmy Hyman and Luke Fowler's favor, folks. As great as Jimmy Hyman and Luke Fowler are, this episode took no chance here tonight. I mean, I don't know who came up with the idea of putting this match on the cover, but when you put Vaughn Kreed and Lord Magma in a fatal four-way, the other two just don't stand a chance.
Here's your winner, Lord Magma.
Despite all this Vicious and Vaughn Kreed drama, it's safe to say that at least Vaughn Kreed is still loyal to Lord Magma, the Nation of Violence. Guess what? I don't know if it's after this. I guess the Nation of Violence is still as strong as ever, despite Vaughn Kreed and Vicious not seeing eye to eye. But looks like we could have a huge tag team main event. Let's go back to this to see what Destroyer and Gene Starling have to say. Of course, they'll be teaming up together tonight in the main event to become Rampage and Samoa Joe. Gene Starr is absolutely right. You just don't know what's going to come out of tonight's main event. I mean, for crying out loud, he's going up against Samoa Joe, the man he's been facing at Love at First Fight in the one-way ticket Money in the Bank ladder match. But then again, look at the Destroyer. He's already he's going to be facing Rampage, not only tonight in tag team action, but he'll be facing him in the main event at Love at First Fight for the UWA title. Potentially, one of those two men could be facing Gene Stone in the main event at Pandemonium 11. Of course, the Rampage wants to continue his title reign. And of course, the Destroyer, he's guaranteed that he's going to be a part of the main event this year at Pandemonium from his hometown of Heathensville, Hemlon. But up next, folks, this is not a match. You see Mona Loca come down to the ring, the co-winner of the 2011 Double X Score Experiment, of course, they're being Coco. Both Coco and Mona Loca have to get to the ground at the same time, both being eliminated from the match, thus the enforcer. Both Coco and Mona Loca going to get a main event opportunity for the Women's Champion at Pandemonium as the Women's Champion. That love the first fight, Coco and Mona Loca will continue their rivalry for whoever wins over the pick of stipulation at Pandemonium 11. Exactly what Mona Loca promised us last week. He's going to call out Coco and reveal to the entire world what truly went down between Mona Loca and Mickie James. Of course, Coco had already, I guess, he just been jumped the gun and jumped to conclusions soon. Now, Mona Loca has something to do with Mickie James leaving UWA abruptly, you know, last year, like around July. You know, just late July, just weeks before Beach Party Slam. Last year, Coco and Mickie James were scheduled to face Stacy Hardy and Flames in a Women's Tag Team Championships in a ladder match. And this the episode of Assault Before Beach Party Slam, Mickie James, without any hesitation, without any acknowledgement or any warning whatsoever, just up and left the UWA and has abandoned her pecking partner and best friend Coco. The Coco had to settle for a team of Athena, despite winning. Their win was short-lived because Olivia Ariano and Paris Sayup did not actually cash in on their tag team title contracts on the Coco and Athena ladder for the matchup. So that was short-lived. But folks, we'll see what happens. Coco has to say, or what will they say for Coco? That cheap shot on Mona Loca, taking down, giving her the boots there. Is what we're coming to expect from Coco. Of course, Coco is assuming, even though Mona Loca did not directly lead to Mickie James quitting the UWA after everything Mona Loca just said. Of course, Coco just assuming it was all Mona Loca's fault, which of course would lead to this brouhaha here. Because these two are going to get a little first fight started early here tonight on Assault Episode 44. Look at this, and oh, that huge gut buster by Mona Loca there. Man, you see this hit, I just hate her so much. I mean, Coco obviously hits Mona Loca for obvious reasons, for all this Mickie James nonsense, of course, just like Mickie James and so many others. Look at this, Coco, this Cristo applied, has total resentment for Mona Loca for her, you know, her spot in UWA, and all that huge running knee. Of course, these two women, they did not want to share the win at square of the spread. They wanted to be the sole winner to get that 1-on-1 match for the women's championship at Pandemonium. I guess they're going to share that glory at Heathens Row. Look at, obviously, these two can't wait till the first fight to sell their differences, but folks, knowing, just judging the hate between these two women, they're going to try to perhaps injure or end the career of each other so that way they don't make it to Pandemonium, perhaps. This Mona Loca in the corner is, oh, that huge alley-oop.
Finally, Mona Loca starting to fend for herself. The Coco's just been dominating her ever since this brouhaha broke out. And my God, it's so violent between these two. Gosh, Coco inside out, that release-driven suplex. It's setting her up for something here. It's going to be that huge, oh, yes, it is, that huge gut buster. Man, that's a really bad way to burst someone's stomach right there.
Never seen Mona Loca do that move before. Well, she must have learned it when she was recuperating from her injuries. And a lot of part of last year from Ursula Arellano put her on the shelf. And look at this. Now Coco, that huge Hurricane Rana there. This is going to be exactly what we're going to see. I love it, first fight, but they'll be competing for opportunity to pick the stipulation at Pandemonium. Look at this. Throwing punches and haymakers, mounting each other on the mat. Look at this. Oh, now, yeah, now Father Security gets involved. I mean, we even had female security here in UWA. And folks, I guess the security finally broke that fight up. I guess the UWA is just forcing us to wait till Love at First Fight to see these two. They'll settle their differences at Love at First Fight. You know, we've said so many times how documented this hatred between Mona Loca and Coco goes all the way back for his last year Beach Party Slam, but it could end up this year's Pandemonium just a few months away. Let's show you how tremendous this huge event could be.
I show up.